At this time, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to present Police Officer Kevin Shaw, who will be singing our national anthem.
Present!
By the dawn's early light, what so proudly we hailed, by the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous night, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming. And the rocket's red glare, the bomb bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave.
Thank you, Police Officer Kevin Shaw. Now I'd like to present Father Jordan here to do the invocation.
Parade, rest.
Thank you, everyone, for coming here today on this wonderful event. It honors our veterans, not just on November 11th, but also here on the first Saturday of August. So thank you all who come to us, brother with Gerard Ward, Charlie Cannon, many others who help put these matters together. We really, truly thank you for your wonderful event. How about a nice hand for Gerard? Thank you, Gerard. Thank you very much for joining us, especially for the veterans, including my own father, Jerry Jordan, the World War II vet. Thank you so much, and let us pray. Gracious, loving God, we thank you for on this Veterans Day, for all who served in the armed forces of the United States, will be overseas right here in our country. Give them inner peace and strength. And Lord, let us not forget our prisoner of wars missing in action. We'll not forget them. We sent them there, we should bring them back. Remember all those who give the ultimate sacrifice for God and country, protect our freedom and democracy. Protect our troops, protect the NYPD, going through tough times right now. Give them inner peace and support to our police department, plus the fire department, and all those who serve this great city. We thank you to Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you, Father. At this time, I'd just like to invite General Manager of the Co-op, Mr. Chris Norton, just to say a few words.
I'm not sure I deserve all the applause. Thank you very much. I just wanted to say I want to keep here. It's a lot nicer weather than we had last year. So that's good. Thank God for that. On behalf of the Board of Directors, we have some Board of Directors here, Paul Dosher, Tom Whip, Chris Hyland, and the Breezy Point Cooperative. We really want to extend our deepest thanks and gratitude to all the veterans, to all those who have lost their lives, the families who have been impacted by it. It's a great honor to be actually down here in General Manager for this community, which is just a great and supporting community. So thank you all very much. Please give yourselves a hand. Thank you.
Thank you, Chris. At this time, we'd like to have Colleen Dalton up. She's going to be reading the names of all the active Breezy members of the military.
Hi, good morning, everyone. James Hayhurst, Kevin Carney, Michael Hollis, Donnie Santasiri, Dennis Cashin, Ronald Brown, Brad Stoltz, Christopher Jameson, Michael K. Watson, Joseph Finn II, Kevin T. Walsh, Kevin O'Hara, Bobby Gerard, Eric Riley, Daniel Campbell, Lawrence Taylor Alvello, Philip Gotti, Robert Andrew Malloy, Frederick Britton, Kevin McCabe, Mark Dennington, Keith Gallagher, Daniel J. Gillen, Eric P. Glasser, Michael R. Nilsson, Gary T. Hunt, Greg Capabianco, Christopher W. Knowles, Elena Marino, Michael Capabianco, Thomas Gabrielli, Mandy Gabrielli, Kevin Logar, Tom Kelly, James Hegarty, James Thompson, and Patrick Durante. Thank you.
Thank you, Colleen. We ask you to please remember our deceased members of the community who were called home during the last year. Their names are Tom Kendrick, who served in the U.S. Air Force in Korea, John Russ Sullivan, U.S. Army, and Chuck Irvine, U.S. Army. Keep them in your thoughts and prayers. At this time, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to invite Beth Ward up to recite the poem, Just a Common Soldier.
Good morning, everyone. He was getting old and paunchy, and his hair was falling fast. And he sat around the Legion telling stories of the past, of a war that he had fought in and the deeds that he had done. In his exploits with his buddies, they were heroes, everyone. And though sometimes to his neighbors his tales became a joke, all his Legion buddies listened, for they knew whereof he spoke. But we'll hear his tales no longer, for old Bill has passed away, and the world's a little poorer, for a soldier died today. He will not be mourned by many, just his children and his wife, for he lived an ordinary and quite uneventful life. Held a job, raised a family, quietly going his own way, and the world won't note his passing, though a soldier died today. Is the greatest contribution to the welfare of our land a guy who breaks his promises and cons his fellow man? Or the ordinary fellow who in times of war and strife goes off to serve his country and offers up his life? He was just a common soldier and his ranks are growing thin, but his presence should remind us we may need his like again. For when countries are in conflict, when we find the soldier's part, is to clean up all the troubles that the politicians start. If we cannot do him honor while he's here to hear the praise, then at least let's give him homage at the ending of his days. Perhaps just a simple headline in a paper that would say, our country is in mourning for a soldier died today.
Thank you, Beth. Beautiful reading. Now, Bev Hegarty, we invite Bev up to recite the poem, The Silent Soldiers.
The Silent Soldiers. Our brave men and women have said their goodbyes. Their families were waving with teardrops in their eyes. The men and women left behind while their spouses go to war try to explain to their children what we're fighting for. Every time a call comes in, whenever the doorbell rings, they shudder at the awful thought of what bad news war could bring. You are the silent soldiers, doing much more than your share. And though we haven't seen you, we know that you are there. To all the children waiting and to the families and friends, we hope that very shortly your loved ones will be home again. The sacrifices you will endure of facing each new day, you too have our prayers and support. Bless you and our USA.
Thank you, Beth. At this time, I'd like to invite Steve Ryan up He's going to be making a presentation.
Good morning, everyone. Can I trouble Kevin McCann, our post commander, to come forward and have the FW post? Many of you know Kevin in the community, and he helps not just veterans, but anyone in need. Felt it appropriate at this time to make this presentation on the history of the United States Marine Corps to Kevin, and I would just like to read the inscription. To Kevin McCann, Captain, United States Marine Corps, retired. This history of the USMC is presented to you in recognition of your leadership in helping veterans in the Breezy Point community. The U.S. Marines builds leaders, and you are an example of that leadership. You have extended help to all seeking guidance. The Breezy Point community is truly blessed in having you. VFW Post 8540.
Thank you very much. I'm going to read the book. I was also on part of the movie.
Congratulations, Governor. I just want to add one name to the deceased members this year. That would be the Brooklyn District Attorney, Joe Hines, who passed away this year as well. So keep him in your thoughts and prayers.
And Thomas Dalton, too.
Thomas Dalton. All right, fine. The names are popping up here now. Okay, very good. At this time, I'd like to invite all the veterans that may be in the audience, all the veterans to the field, behind the assembled group, if they would step up. We'd love to see you out there. Just step up and be honored with the rest of the gentlemen and ladies that are standing behind you. We thank all of you for your service. At this time, we will have the raising of the flag. Thank you. Thank you, Grace.